In this video, we are going to show what are the characteristics of the glaucomatous optic disc atrophy in advanced glaucoma. First, we will see a thinning of the neuroretinal rim, containing the axons of ganglion cells. This thinning of the neuroretinal rim reflects the loss of ganglion cells due to glaucomatous damage. The circle represents the normal optic disc upsize in a patient without glaucoma. As glaucomatous damage progresses, the optic disc cap becomes larger and often deeper. As the neuroretinal rim thins from ganglion cell loss, the lamina cribosa is exposed and its perforated surface can be clearly seen. Pallor of the optic nerve is classically considered a change in glaucoma. The term pallor is likely to be misinterpreted to mean generalized pallor of the optic nerve. The pallor of glaucomatous optic nerve relates to the increased visibility of the lamina cribosa at optic disc, as compared to the colored neuroretinal rim that has been lost. In a healthy disc, vessels pass over the sloping rim of the cap to reach the retina. This creates a mild kink or change in direction of the vessel. With loss of the neuroretinal rim, a vessel might pass into a recess below the rim before climbing onto its surface. This creates a double angulation, a Z-shaped bend, which looks like a bayonet. Bayonet sign is a characteristic sign of advanced glaucoma. Thank you so much for your attention.